We're joined now by John Hofmeister. He's a former Shell Oil president, currently the CEO of Citizens for Affordable Energy, and he comes to us from Houston. Thank you for joining us this morning. Sir, I know you have your doubts, but what are we going to learn from the hearings today taking place on Capitol Hill? What instructive lessons will we learn?
Well, I think one thing that will be learned is how committed the companies are to safety and health. People may have some prejudiced views about that, but as an insider to the industry, I can tell you that no industry approaches health and safety more seriously than the oil and gas industry. And so I think we will hear that reinforced. What we won't hear are what really went wrong. It's too soon to know what really went wrong, and that will frustrate a lot of listeners.
Are the company executives the right witnesses to be calling at this point? You were saying it's too soon to tell. Who should we be hearing from then?
Well, I think it's kind of early to hear from anybody who has a knowledgeable grasp of all the facts that need to be considered. I understand Congress's urgency to appear to be in the middle of this great crisis that we're having in the Gulf, but, you know, it really does put an assumption that people can speak freely about what they don't know. And so I think people are going to come away frustrated and ask themselves, what did this really accomplish? Because until the well is stopped, until the oil is pretty well cleaned up, until we've examined the equipment, the processes, done all the witness testimony through the investigatory process within the companies, it's really going to be months before we know exactly what happened and at what precise moment did things take place.
One thing this oil spill has really shown us is the level of outsourcing that's taking place in the oil industry, in the offshore drilling industry. You're pretty critical of outsourcing, is that right?
I'm critical of outsourcing when it loses the expertise within the major operator who has to oversee all the outsourced activities. So, if a company is going to choose to outsource certain competencies to truly professional firms, and there's no doubt, Transocean, Halliburton, they are truly professional firms. But what the major operator still needs to have inside their own company is the expertise equal to or greater than that expertise which they're buying from another source. I'm also concerned about the chain of command on a rig. Is the chain of command clear to everyone? Because when you have multiple corporate entities working on a rig and you have differences of opinion, you could end up with corporate disagreements, but that translates into personal disagreements in what on the rig is really a small village. And when you can't dissipate the tensions in that small village because of the corporate differences of opinion, then you could have real problems on your hands. So rig management is a really critical resource, and it has to be clear who's in charge of what at all moments.
Yeah, something for the executives to answer to, certainly. Now, BP CEO Tony Hayward has said that the implications from the oil leak for the industry may be pretty severe. Can you decipher that for us? What might he be suggesting but not really spelling out for us?
Well, the worst case is if this country, for whatever reasons, decides to abandon offshore drilling. That would be horrific for the consumers of America, because it would put more burden on the global supply pool to not only take care of China, India, Europe, and other countries around the world that don't have oil, but here we are in the U.S. with an abundance of oil, but we refuse to drill it for various reasons. The consumers would bear the brunt of it, which means the citizens of the U.S. For political purposes, we should not take what will in time be looked upon as a tragic but anomalous situation. We have thousands of wells that don't blow up, and we'll have many thousands more if the industry is permitted to continue drilling without blowing up. But taking an anomaly and turning it into a public policy would be a grievous error on the part of our government. I don't think they'll do it, but there will be those who call for it.
Do you think we'll see more regulation as a result of this incident?
I suspect we will, and frankly, I'm not opposed to it. If we can learn what went wrong, and if we can regulate so everybody in the industry operates to the set of regulations and build additional redundancy through technology into the process. I can't imagine any company not wanting to embrace better technology, new technology, which would reduce or eliminate the kind of risk that we faced here. It will always be a risky industry. Mm. There's no way around that. Hydrocarbons are risky business. But mitigating the risk, if we can learn and apply, then I think it's well worth it to do so.
All right. Thank you so much. We've been speaking with John Hofmeister, former president of Shell Oil.